At first, the children looked nervous, but when we showed them the balls, they gave us big smiles. It was like a magic.
If you're honestly thinking about taking a reasonably long journey in Japan, I would honestly consider taking a coffin, because you are going to need it by the time you reach the end of your destination, should you reach the end of your destination.
What is love? I asked. Miss Sullivan held me close and said, "It is here," and touched my chest. Her words puzzled me. Yeah.
Oh. Oh, for a minute there, I thought I was living in an alternate reality where instead of people eating Christmas turkey sprouts and stuffing on Christmas Day, people were lining up to pre-order premium KFC from a premium Christmas menu. Oh, wait.
But the day didn't really inspire a sense of Christmas spirit. What with going to work at an empty high school, getting a substandard haircut, and popping over to North Korea for the North Korean air show. Quill helped Mr. Watanabe as a guide dog and learned many things. Two happy years passed. However, their happy days did not last longer than this. Mr. Watanabe became ill and went into hospital. Mr. Watanabe died. Oh. Let's vitamin.
Just the other day, I walked past a poster for a rap concert being headlined by Trailers Trash with supporting acts from Highbridge and Brown Shit. I'd probably avoid their album artwork.
And yeah, look forward to seeing you soon.
I'll be waiting right here.
Next week, I'll be discussing how I potentially saved the world from an all-out nuclear holocaust whilst on a trip to Seattle in 2008 when I bought a George Foreman grill and a pencil sharpener. So find out about that next week. I took advantage of the calm atmosphere and tried to get myself a much welcome break in the toilet. But unfortunately, it turned out the toilet had been imported straight out of a children's fucking nightmare. So if you think you can handle it, get yourself down to Kagaya Bar in Tokyo. Because even if you don't enjoy it, you can still have fun confusing your friends when you try and explain you saw a guy lick an easel, toss off a menu, and run around with a frog named Dick. And then, and this is the bit I'm really excited about, I discovered the extent of my fame. It turns out I have the 26,592nd most famous birthday in the world. Over 7 billion birthdays, and I have the 26,592nd most famous. And I looked at this, and it just hit me how famous I am, which is, of course, very, very famous. So it is significant. Don't take my fame away from me. It's... Oh, fuck, who am I kidding? I'm not famous. Famousbirthdays.com. It's not even a good website. They got my birthday wrong. You are Oh wait, there's no full stop there. A fucking faggot. I'll sit down and have a read through whilst eating some kind of awkwardly named Japanese confectionery. Fuck off! This is about the Revolutionary War again, isn't it?
No, it's not.
Why? Why can't you just forget? It was like 200 years ago. I don't even think I was there.
Fuck you and fuck your party hats, Rachel.
From buying airline tickets to paying your water and electricity bills. Unless, like me, you can't read your bills, so you just put them in this special Japanese cupboard designed to put your bills in, because you're not going to pay for something you can't read.
Mr. Brain's pork faggots. I always found the combination of Mr. Brain's and a picture of these pork faggots, I always found that quite distasteful and a bit of a turn-off.
Fucking horrible. Oh!
But I love staying in hotel rooms. It makes me feel like some kind of clever, successful businessman who's really made it in life. But unfortunately, the reality is somewhat different. The fact that my worldly possessions are stuffed into two bags over by that table, and my glamorous hotel view consists of a roof covered in a never-ending sea of air conditioning units, certainly does take some of the magic away from it all. And instead of making business deals worth millions, I've sat here for 25 minutes now pondering a difficult decision I faced over last night's dinner. I was at this cheap sushi restaurant, and after the main meal, there were two desserts that caught my eye, a pudding and a premium pudding. And the trouble was, the prices, the pictures and the descriptions didn't really make any sense. Because the picture of the mere pudding looked marginally better than the picture of the premium pudding, despite having the same price. And I just didn't know what to do. Maybe the pictures were the wrong way around, or maybe in Japan, premium puddings don't come with cream. I don't know, I'm not a Japanese pudding expert by any measure. In the end, I couldn't decide, so I just went with the mousse of the mango. But it certainly was one of the greatest dilemmas I faced in 2016 so far.
You have to put your thumb in like that. Probably. It's quite therapeutic. I feel very, very relaxed doing this.
Yeah.
See, I don't like to have the same things all the time. I like to be original, and this is the definition of originality. Oh, a YouTube comment. Your accent makes me want to be sick on myself. I cannot emphasize the absence of sound. My breath sounded like a roar. Someone just liked my picture on Instagram. I thought, oh, it's cherry blossom in there, it'll taste nice. Nope, it's like seawater in a cup with some flowers in.
My friend in Hong Kong, her name was Creamy.
Trying to keep a straight face after you tell me.
Ruin the atmosphere of the tea ceremony with your ridiculous...
creamy friend.
Ridiculous creamy friend. Wow, there's an owl and then a samurai sword.
One, two, three.
Greatest slurping you've ever seen.
I don't get any hate mail these days. Everyone loves this channel. The Abroad in Japan channel brings joy and laughter to thousands all around the world. Your humour is so bad, it gave me depression.
What?
Send me a cheque for $50 and I'll reveal the secrets to flying hair absolutely free. Get out of your silly country and expand your little mind. I did, you muppet. That's why I'm abroad in Japan. Anyway, after that, I went off to grab some lunch, and on the way I passed through the local nightlife district. And to my surprise, I stumbled across a secret, sexy club. But how do I know it was a secret, sexy club? Well, it said so on the 30-foot billboard out the front. And one part of the chicken set alarm bells ringing. It was a part of the chicken labelled as... Bon Jovi.
You've found the secret loft, well done.
It's probably the best sandwich I've ever had. Or I'll kill myself.
Move over, Avengers. Planting Tree Man's in town. Is he?
Oh my god, guys, monkey basketball. Look at this monkey.
So that was the new style of vlogging.
Look at them. Peddling so efficiently in their swan boat while I'm not even moving. Bastards. Whenever I get in a boat, I feel like I want to be some kind of pirate, you know, I'm going to sink them, take them down. Although I'm a bit more worried about my boat. It's of questionable buoyancy, and there's a few $1,000s worth of cameras that I brought on here with me. I feel a real strong bond with so many of my viewers through the wonderful and appreciative comments that I regularly receive. It's a bond that feels almost spiritual in so many ways.
Ha ha ha, you fat!
Oh, funny guy.
Oh my god, I genuinely hate everyone and everything that's existed ever. Stupid people!
Naturally, it's quite expensive.
On top of the bears, they've got North Korean missiles. It's a bit unfortunate. I've come here to hike through a forest, and while I was prepared to accept the danger of the bears, the missiles certainly add another element to that.
What the fucking light, come on. I could climb up that staircase, or I could take the patronisingly small escalator. Yeah! Could lift the toilet seat up, but it is quite difficult. I know, I'll press this button. Yeah!
So guys, I like to start my day with a coconut mango milk life shake. It's so full of vitamins and minerals, zinc, copper, cyanide, everything is in this. It's so, oh fuck me, so delicious.
As per usual, the best English comes on sanitary products, in this case a toilet seat cover, which just says, let's choose the favourite colour from a lot of colours. Best thing about Don Quixote, everything is overwhelmingly priced. I'm not even making this. Overwhelming price.
Swear to be bold.
Bold.
Swear to be different.
Different.
Swear to be provocative.
Provocative.
Provocative, the new fragrance from Noah Shirakawa. Break all the rules, just don't swear in public.
I read it in a magazine once, but apparently if you juxtapose something that you're afraid of with unconventional sounding music, it can actually cure you of that fear because you see it from a kind of a different perspective. So with that in mind, yeah, it didn't work, did it?
Go! Ah! Ah! Ah!
Ah! But look, you can pull this down. Ha ha! And now you can't see me. There we go. Ha ha!
I can sit here and think about how to make the world a better place. I'll do that later, though. I'll do that later.
All right. What can we do to make our restaurant more visually appealing? How can we improve its appearance? And presumably the answer to that question had been, let's put a dozen human centipede figurines out the front of the restaurant. And instead of hearing a phrase like Gotisaur Samadeshta, in the UK you're more likely to hear, oi, where's your TV remote? I want to watch Top Gear. If I contrast that again to 9 years ago when my Xbox 360 broke after showing the Red Ring of Death, I still quite clearly remember running it over 3 times in my Vauxhall Vectra. Such was my frustration. Bastard had the last laugh though. It punctured a hole through my tyre and cost me another £70.
Hello.
Yeah. Looking forward to the 4K videos?
Please get a 4K camera.
Bro, you really need to start filming in 4K ultra high definition video.
Ultra high definition 4K.
Louis CK.
8K Super Cockasaurus.
4K video, eh?
I went off in the other direction and started planning my gap year. Now, some people spend their gap year travelling the world, swimming with dolphins and building villages in Africa. And to me, that's what I wanted to do. I wanted a year of unbridled adventure and discovery, and it was gonna be amazing. And then I got a full-time office job, staring at Excel spreadsheets for 40 hours a week, and it was the worst year of my life ever. It was the sort of shop sign that you have to stop and look up at in disbelief, because it's not every day that you see a clothes shop called Sperm. And staring up at that shop sign, I thought to myself, I wonder which people actively choose to purchase their clothes from Sperm. Perhaps it's people captivated by the shop's promising tagline. I never thought freedom was cheap. However, presumably, when my application was reviewed a few months later by some people in a room, they looked at my application and said, he wants to live in Kobe, does he? I know. Let's send him to a rice field about 1,000 kilometers away from Kobe.
About 4 months ago, I decided to switch to a healthy breakfast. It was part of my incredible plan to gradually lose weight throughout the year. So my breakfast routine has been comprised of oatmeal, black coffee, and a banana. Only problem is, I still haven't lost any weight. This breakfast routine has failed to bear any fruit. Well, apart from the banana. But its true value lies here on the back of the oven glove with this powerful philosophical statement which resonated with me on an emotional level. I'll read it out. It says, "This is me. To be yourself in a world that is constantly trying to make you something else is the greatest accomplishment." And I read that and I thought, yes, that is me. That is how I define accomplishment. Only thing that compromises that bold statement here is the question underneath, and it is a question that reads, "What your favourite colour?" What your favourite colour? Oh my god, that's the best view I've ever seen in my entire life! It's what I would have said if we could actually see it. 6 years I've waited for this view and it is magnificent. It's what I would have said if we'd seen Mount Fuji, but it's not here again.
I won't lie, I'm a little bit scared. I'm a little bit scared.
Joey, when I asked you to come on this cycle, did you ever imagine you'd be having a Sapporo beer on a beach next to the world's biggest nuclear power plant whilst a Nintendo 64 controller was behind you and there was a big waifu pillow stuck to your bicycle?
Yes.
Excellent.
Right.
When I was a kid, I always wanted drums. I always wanted a drum kit, but my parents couldn't afford it.
Right.
Very sad. Very sad indeed.
So what I've got here is the Donkey Kong drum kit, right? So now, whenever I'm bored...
Is that during the cycle? Because then you have to take both hands off your handlebars.
True, it's a bit of a health hazard, not gonna lie. Worse still, I can't actually turn the bike wheel.
Right, so that's the challenge of the day. Yay. Explore some abandoned spooky places.
Let's go.
And not Niigata Petting Zoo.
No, fucking Niigata Petting Zoo. Let's go to Petting Zoo.
Went to the terrifying tunnel of horror. This guy is running so fast.
He just came back from the terrifying tunnel.
He's running faster than we were going on the bike.
Yeah.
Cycle. バイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイクバイク ドクタージェリー全国のコンビニで発売中。